Hello everyone, welcome to GeekHigh TV, and this is my first YouTube video on this channel. In this video, I'll be showing you all some of the basic tools and techniques used in Adobe Photoshop. I'm using Adobe Photoshop CC 2015, but the latest version is CC 2017. But both are actually similar. Photoshop is the most powerful photo editing software. So before getting into the tutorial, let us know the system requirements of this application. Alright, now let us open the application. Photoshop mainly works on the principle of layers. Keeping that in mind, let us get started. Now, open a file or a project. Click on the file button and then press new. Here, set the name you want. Here you can set the canvas size. You can keep it as custom and then change the width and height, or can select the US paper, and then if you're working on a letter or A4 size, A4 size, choose the document type as international paper and then the size as A4. Let us work on the custom size, and I'll set this as centimeters, and this one as 30, and this as 30 as well, and then the resolution. The resolution is the key factor which determines the clarity of your image. The higher the resolution, the higher the image size. And then the color mode. You can set any of these and then select one. I am choosing RGB, that is red, green and blue, or you can choose CMYK, but I prefer RGB. And then this is the number of bits, select any of those. And then the background contents, I am choosing white. And you can also choose background color or transparent one. I'm choosing white. Okay, so we have created a canvas and we are going to work on this thing. Now let us import some of the images. Click on file and then open and select any of your JPEG files or PNG files, anything you want. I'm choosing this one and press open. It should open in a separate tab. When you want to copy this into your canvas, make sure that this is unlocked, and this is the move tool. Move this here and then drop it here. Now we have dropped our image on this canvas, but the image looks pretty small. To enlarge this, we are going to transform it, and the option is found in the edit tab, and press on free transform or transform. I choose free transform and then enlarge it and then press enter when you are confirmed. But the aspect ratio of this image has been distorted, and so I'm going to choose this link button to keep the aspect ratios intact. Enlarge it as much as you want. Here you find the tick mark which says to commit and this one to cancel it, or you can press enter to confirm it. And now we have enlarged the image. Similarly, to get another image, do the same process. This is similar to the Microsoft Word. You must be familiar with that. Click on file, open the second image, open and the same thing, unlock it, and then you're free to move this image. Go to the first tab and then drop it here. Let me enlarge this. And the other shortcut to transform the image with its aspect ratio intact, hold on shift button and then drag it, press enter to confirm it. So now we have moved two images in our canvas. As you can see, the second image overlaps on the first one, and that is because the layer 2 here is placed on top of the first layer. So whenever you drag this below the layer 1, you find that the layer 1 is on top and the layer 2 is at the bottom. You can also rename these layers by double clicking on the name and setting the name you want. Say pick 1, press enter. Pick 2. The next tool is the rectangular marquee tool. Here you can use it to select a part of the image and then choose any of these options for the selections. The next one is the lasso tool. The lasso tool helps you in the same way in the free transform. I have chosen this, and there are other options you can find in lasso tool by pressing and holding it to get the options like polygonal lasso tool. You can select the part of the image by forming a polygon, or You can choose a magnet tool, which actually selects the part of the image by itself depending on the gradient of the image. Did you see that? So, by this tool, you can move the part selected by clicking on Ctrl and then dragging the mouse to move the selected object, and click on Ctrl Z to undo it. If you want to undo the previous ones too, then hold on Ctrl Alt and Z. Simple, isn't it? So let us see the next tool. This
tool is the quick selection. Click on this, and this enables the user to select specific part of the image. Now I'm going to select this man, and as you can see that it is also selecting the unwanted part. For this you have to hold on Alt and then move it across the unwanted part. And there you go. We have selected a part of the image. To increase or decrease the size of this, you can choose here by moving this cursor up and down, or you can also click the square brackets for enlarging or decreasing the size. To precisely select an image, hold on Alt and then scroll up and decrease the size. And then select the image precisely. I don't want to do this now. And to zoom out, hold on Alt and scroll down. Or you can press on Ctrl 0 to fit on screen. You have selected it, and if you want to move this object, hold on Ctrl and click here. And Ctrl Z if you want to undo it. To deselect it, go to lasso tool and just click anywhere you want. The next is the magic wand. Magic wand helps you in selecting the particular object immediately based on the image's gradient. Till now we were working on this image. I want to work on this image. So for this, make sure that you have clicked on the layer shown here as pick 2. If you don't find this layers column, you can go to the window option and then select layers and check it. Now I'll zoom in and I want to select this part, so I'm just going to click on this and that's it. We have selected the required part. If you want to still extend it, then hold on Shift and click the parts which you like. Let us see the next one. It is the crop tool. The crop tool enables you to remove the unwanted part of the image. You can just drag it up and down, and as you can see that the aspect ratio is fixed. So to change this, you have to check this to make a free transformation of the crop selection tool, and then press commit to confirm your image selection. For now, let us undo this. If you're working on a particular image, then you can uncheck this eye mark to disable it or enable it.
Now let us add some text to this image by clicking on this type tool. Say mountains. Here the text is white. To change the color of this, select here and then go to color and then select any color to change it. And there you go. You can see that there is an additional layer called mountains added right below the pick 1. You can also draw some of the shapes by clicking on this tool, and you find a number of tools like rectangle tool, ellipse tool, polygon tool, etc. And I am choosing rectangle tool. Let us select pick 1 and then draw a rectangle on this picture. You can select the fill inside this and you can set it as red, or the stroke, the outer boundary, to some other color, say black, and you can change the width of the stroke by decreasing or increasing this, and then you can change the stroke style by these options. Fine, let us undo this. There is eraser tool, and click on pick 1 and then you can erase any unwanted portion of the pic. Now let me undo this. We have seen all the necessary tools used in Photoshop, and now the final stage is to render this image. So click on File, Save As, and then type the file name. There are three things to be known. If you want to make any changes in future, then it is better to save as .psd file. Or if you want the final image, then check .jpg. Press save. Sometimes the image can have a transparent background. At that point of time, we have to select .png file for saving as a JPEG file. Press on .jpg, then save. Select the quality of image. If you render with a higher quality, size of the file is larger. Press OK, and that is it. Photoshop is really interesting to work on, so keep exploring other tools present in the application and do keep practicing to master it. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this helpful, then please give a thumbs up. If there are any queries or suggestions, please do comment in the comment section below for improving my future videos. Subscribe to this channel to be notified for other tutorials. See you in my next video. Bye-bye.